What's up, dudes, and what's up, ladies? Brian here, and in this nutritional journey, we're going to enter the wonderful world of amino acids. We're going to look at exactly what they are, what they do, and foods that are rich in amino acids. So, time to roll!
We're going to start by looking at the molecular structure of a typical amino acid. Don't worry, I'm going to make this easy to understand. So the basic structure of amino acids is that they consist of a carboxyl group, a lone hydrogen atom, an amino group, and a side chain. This side chain is often referred to as the R group. The formation of the side chain is what makes amino acids different from one another. As you can see in this diagram, these four are all connected to a carbon atom, which is referred to as the alpha carbon. Now, not every amino acid follows this exact structure, but most do. On the screen, I have three different amino acids, lysine, tryptophan, and leucine. You can see that each has a carboxyl group, an alpha carbon, an amino group, and an R group that is different from one another. There are a total of 23 amino acids that are proteinogenic. Proteinogenic amino acids are precursors to proteins, which means that they are compounds that participate in a chemical reaction to produce another compound. Of these 23 amino acids, 20 of them are called standard amino acids, and the other three are non-standard amino acids. These are listed on the screen. In this video, we're going to focus on the standard amino acids, as they are what make up proteins. These amino acids can be classified many different ways. We're going to classify them in a basic nutritional way, essential and non-essential. Essential amino acids cannot be made by the body, so they must come from foods we eat. Non-essential amino acids are amino acids that our bodies can produce, even if we don't get them from the food we eat. There are 9 essential and 11 non-essential amino acids. I've listed them on the screen. So, how do amino acids form proteins? Well, proteins are built from the 20 standard amino acids. The first thing that happens is that two amino acids come together to form what's called a peptide bond. A peptide bond is when the carboxyl group of one amino acid bonds with the amino group of another amino acid, as you can see here. If you notice, two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom have been removed from the peptide bonding process. So the peptide bonding results in the release of a water molecule, H2O. But we're not finished. More amino acids can link in and form what's called a polypeptide chain. Some proteins are single polypeptide chains, and other proteins have polypeptide chains linked together. Keep in mind that not all protein contains all 20 of the standard amino acids. Proteins are often labeled as complete or incomplete protein. A complete protein is a protein source that contains a sufficient quantity of all 9 of the essential amino acids that we discussed earlier. An incomplete protein does not contain a sufficient quantity of all 9 of the essential amino acids. Complete protein foods include animal foods such as red meat, poultry, pork, and fish, eggs and dairy products such as cow's milk, yogurt, and cheese, plant foods such as soy products, black beans, kidney beans, pumpkin seeds, quinoa, pistachios, just to name a few. You can also combine incomplete protein foods to create a complete protein meal or to get the essential amino acids throughout the day. Amino acids also make up most enzymes. These enzymes are proteins, so they are made by linking amino acids together in a specific and unique order. This chain of amino acids then forms a unique shape that allows the enzyme created to serve a single specific purpose. Enzymes function as catalysts, which means that they speed up the rate at which metabolic processes and reactions occur. Amino acids can also be metabolized for energy. Some hormones like epinephrine, also known as adrenaline, are amino acid derived. Some neurotransmitters like serotonin are derived from amino acids. The amino acid arginine is a precursor of nitric oxide, which helps regulate blood pressure, improves sleep quality, and increases endurance and strength. Glutathione, which is a powerful antioxidant, is also formed from amino acids.
Bottom line time. As you can see, amino acids have many important roles in the body. Your focus should be on eating a balanced diet that includes foods that have an adequate amount of the essential amino acids. A great approach? Eat a variety of foods every single day. All right. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them below. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't like the video, hit the thumbs down, man. It's all good. Till next time, I'm out. See ya.